What is going on, guys? My name is Jesse Eby. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm dropping weekly content in regards to e-commerce, Shopify dropshipping, and everything online entrepreneurship. So Shopify product research. Everybody wants to know how to find a winning product for Shopify dropshipping. Well, I'm dropping all this content for free and not charging you a thing. So in today's video, I'm gonna be revealing 5 methods that all the Shopify gurus charge for, and I'm gonna be releasing for completely free. So for this movement to succeed, I don't need any money from you, but I do need your support, so please smash that like button, and if you haven't yet, be sure to join the family and click subscribe. All right, let's go ahead and jump right into the content.
All right. So we're gonna go over how to find some winning products. All right, there's a lot of ways you could do this. I'm probably gonna be able to have to break this into multiple videos, but right now I'm gonna compile what has been most beneficial for me, and I'm gonna share it with you all right now. Now, this is the information that the gurus are charging for, and I'm just giving it away for free. So I hope there's some benefits here, and I hope you enjoy. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. All right, so first things first, for people that are doing Shopify product research, there's this very simple Chrome extension tool that should be installed on all of your browsers. And it's gonna allow you to see the historical price fluctuations. It's gonna set the price drop notifications if you want them to. And it's gonna allow you to check the seller analysis information. So I'm gonna show you all this real quick. And I'm gonna leave the link in the description so you guys could add it to your Chrome. It's a free extension. All right, so here we are on AliExpress. I just randomly searched camping. So let's go ahead and, I don't know, this looks cool, let's do that. So when you're on an AliExpress listing with this extension installed, you can see this bar that it gives you down at the bottom here. This is very simple, it's not very complicated, but I'll just show you the benefits of it real quick. So the first one here, when you click this button right here, you can see the historical data of the pricing that this item has been over an extended period of time. Now, the beautiful part of this is if you find it to be at a too high of price, like right now it's at $916 and you see that the low point in the past has been $774. Now you have to account for the shipping price too when you're doing all of this. So if you calculate everything and you find the price point of the product needs to be $774 when accounting for shipping, when you click this button, it actually adds it to your favorites so that you can be notified whenever there's a price drop. One more thing, guys, I almost forgot to mention is this seller analysis section here. When you click this part right here, it gives you all the information about the sellers so you can verify that they are a good option to be buying your products from. Now this tool is super powerful and has brought me a lot of value when doing my Shopify product research. Not too many people know about it, but it's been super beneficial. Now this website is similar to Tinder. If you guys know what Tinder is, that kind of dating app where you swipe left or right depending on if you like a person. Well, this is essentially the same thing, but it's for AliExpress. People are voting on certain items. Certain items are brought to thieve.co and people are voting yes or no on them, and items are voted and the most popular are displayed on their website. So I'll show you guys real quick. See, this is thieve.co, curated by creatives. So you could kind of see, like, this is the latest items, what have just been voted recently or added to the site recently. I like to go to trending and see what kind of trending products are being voted for right now. Now, when you're going through these items, you want to look for items that have, let's say, 50 votes or more. Then you could know it's probably a pretty good item and you could do further research on it. But there's a lot of good information here that can give you some great ideas when doing your Shopify product research. You could also go to most popular. See, look at all the votes these have. Thousands. Wooden alarm clocks. What did I tell you guys in my other videos? I talked about niching down into sub-niches. You could have a home item store that are all wooden products. People like these unique items. Look at all these votes. Thousands. Now, it's important to remember that these items that are super popular might not be something that you and me think are cool. What you and me think is cool does not matter. What matters is what the market enjoys. And what the market enjoys may be completely different than what you, me, or our friends and family like. And we have to cater to the market. Remember, I talked about unique socks in one of my other videos as well. This is pretty cool, a magnetic cloud key holder. All right, that's solving a problem that people have. Everybody loses their keys. How simple is it to throw it on a magnet when you walk in your home? Some really cool stuff here. if I hang out here too much, I'm gonna start buying shit. Oh, but another thing, you can actually look up what items are popular in your niche. So for example, if I'm in the camping niche, I type it in here. You could see popular items and how much they've been voted based on your niche. Like look at this, inflatable bubble tent. And then all you have to do is you click on it. Oh, and just as a bonus tip for when you guys are doing Shopify product research and you find your item on AliExpress, if you're in the camping niche, you might be going through and you have a product here. Well, it's worth clicking this, visit their store. You might be able to find some items that they are selling a lot of in the camping niche. Like, look at that. Now you have a whole world of new options that you may have not seen before. This is just examples, but you see what I mean here. So go ahead and hop on that thieve.co and dig through there. It's super interesting. A lot of fun stuff. If you're not careful, you might end up buying some shit. Okay, now this website is another super powerful website. It's the number one trend firm in the world. It's this massive company called TrendHunter.com. It's dedicated to spotting the most innovative ideas and next upcoming trends around the world. And it's actually utilized by the biggest corporations in the world, like, you know, giant companies. I'm not gonna give them free advertisement here, but you know, giant companies. And I'll show you guys real quick. So this is TrendHunter, but you could kind of dig through and see what they have going on here and just kind of get some ideas. A lot of this Shopify product research is about just getting ideas and kind of getting the wheels turning and sparking ideas. Like maybe you see this toilet and something sparks your imagination and you think of some trending product that you want to look into. But you go here to the best, and as an example here, it looks like there's a artificial intelligence kind of robot window cleaner. So this is pretty cool. It's like that Roomba vacuum cleaner for the floor, but it looks like somehow it suctions to the window and like cleans your entire window. And I bet you AliExpress will have something like this. Yeah, sure enough, AliExpress has basically the same thing in a decent amount of orders as well. So you could dig through TrendHunter and you could find these new trending items and see what kind of sparks your interest. And sometimes when you're going through here, there's some fashion items that you might be able to model as something that you could use for print on demand. And you could go through particular categories and see what items are kind of trending. You know, it'd be hard to sell a regular calculator on a e-commerce store, but a unique kind of trendy futuristic calculator like this might be a little easier. So there's a lot of stuff. You just can dig through and find a lot of options. But anyways, you get the idea. Some very good options there. Another one, watchcount.com. This is a website that's dedicated to compiling all the items off eBay that are commonly added to people's watch lists on eBay. I'll show you guys that here. All right, so here's Watchcount. All right, now as an example, let's look at that robotic window cleaner that we saw off TrendHunter. And as you can see here, there's a handful of watchers. So you could tell that items like this are really in demand. Just as an example, here I search cats. You could see what kind of items in relation to cats are being added to the watch list pretty frequently. It looks like these personalized collars are pretty popular for their animals. These big cat trees. A lot of stuff here that you could dig through and really get an idea of what's popular and trending. It's pretty self-explanatory, but you could go through and you could select different categories: jewelry, watches, crafts, health and beauty. And a lot of this, all it is just really digging through and a lot of trial and error and testing and seeing what's gonna work. And eventually you will break through. If you do not give up, eventually you will break through and you'll find some trending items and you'll be able to make a good living on it. And some of the items will eventually die out and then you rinse and repeat the process. But if you're running your business properly, you'll have returning customers who love your brand.
Whoa.
All right, and another one people don't really think about is Amazon bestsellers. I have the link here, but oftentimes links on websites just change all the time. So I suggest you Google search Amazon bestsellers and just go to the first one here. And this is pretty self-explanatory, but you could go through and you could select the departments that you're looking for and see what the best-selling items are in that particular niche. And this allows you to actually niche down. So if you go into the health and household section, you could actually niche down to be more specific. You could look over here, some of the most wished for. I guess that's kind of like the watch list, like eBay. These are items that people are really interested in. You can look at the new releases. I saw this has been trending a while, this glove that helps groom your pet. So it's just about digging through, just getting ideas and finding items that could potentially be popular. I am the one, the way your son don't need a- I want to share with you guys a few bonuses here. One is coolhunting.com, which is essentially the same thing as trendhunter.com. So it's going to be essentially the same process. You'd go to coolhunting.com/#buy, and you do the same process, just kind of digging through, trying to find good items. And another thing that people don't think of very often is Kickstarter. You could find heavily funded projects that are picking up traction and look for similar items from a supplier like AliExpress. And sometimes they have clothing type items, which you can model and utilize their design or similar design as print on demand items. So this is Kickstarter.com, or we could check popular. You could go through all these and see which ones are heavily funded. Like this one in particular, 675% funded. So people are really interested in this item. Holograph watch.
In 2015, the mechanical watch campaign on Kickstarter.
So that's pretty cool. But it kind of goes to show you how if you're going to be selling watches, it better be something different. It's not just your standard watch. That's why I tell everybody to stay away from the watch and necklace store. Everybody's first thing they want to jump into is selling watches and necklaces, which is fine, but it better be something unique. Like you saw this. So this can just give you some ideas by digging through here, seeing what's popular, and just kind of getting the wheels turning in regards to Shopify product research. All right, I appreciate you guys watching. I'm not selling you anything. I'm providing all the information that the gurus charge for, but I'm providing it for free. So I hope you found some value, and I hope you enjoyed. If you liked the video, be sure to like it. If you hated the video, be sure to dislike it. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment section. Thank you for stopping by. Be sure to subscribe. All right, peace out.